Hello everyone, Namaskar, Rajkrishna this side. Let's solve one more problem from linear differential equation with constant coefficient. So, I have a simple basic problem in front of us. D square plus A square operating on y equals to sine A. So, what is the first step? The first step is to write your auxiliary equation. For that, simply replace this capital D by M. So, you get M square plus A square. Equate it to 0, solve it. So m is plus minus a iota. Fine. So if I write your m1 should be 0 plus a iota and your m2 should be 0 minus a iota. Fine enough. Now, how to find complementary function in case the roots are imaginary? This is simply e power. If you compare 0 plus a iota and 0 minus a iota with a plus iota b, don't get confused. You can also compare it with x minus x plus iota y and x minus iota y. Okay. So you get x equals to 0 in each case and okay. Or you can, if you are getting confused at x also, then you can compare it with p plus iota key and q and p minus iota key. So in each case you are seeing the real part is 0 and the imaginary part is a. So e power real part into x, so e power 0x simply c1 cos imaginary part into x, so imaginary part in this case is a plus c2 sine ax. So complementary function is basically c1 cos ax plus c2 sine ax. Now coming to the particular integral portion, so that is nothing but 1 upon f of d operating on RHS, which is in this case sin ax. So how to find the particular integral for sin ax? First of all, let me write function of d, which is d square plus a square. This is operating on sin ax. Now replace d square by minus of a square. A is nothing but the coefficient of x. So a square, if you replace this d square by minus of a square, the denominator is becoming 0. So we have a concept that if denominator is becoming 0, then multiply by 1x outside, not inside, not at this place, but outside the operator. Okay. And differentiate the denominator. So if you differentiate, you are going to get 2d, derivative of a square is 0, and this sin ax as it is. Now you can either again multiply this by d, so you get d square in denominator, or you can simply use this thing that 1 by d is similar as integration. So this is x by 2 and integral of sin ax dx. So integral of sin is negative of cos. Negative cos ax, and also you have to divide by the derivative or simply the coefficient of x, which is a. So minus x by 2a cos ax. Finally, your y will be cf plus pi. So y will be cf plus pi. That means what was your cf? It was c1 cos ax plus c2 sin ax, and your pi came out to be minus x by 2a cos ax. So this is your final answer for this particular problem. So I hope you understood this. We'll see you with some more problem. You can visit my playlist, which is ordinary differential equation, where I have solved similar problems like this. Otherwise, this was simple. You first find auxiliary equation, then find the complementary function, and then follow it by finding the particular integral. Finally, y equals to cf plus pi. So I hope you understood this. Thanks again.